Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today you're gonna see one of my best productive morning routines. The first thing that I do in the morning, of course after brushing my teeth, is to have a glass full of milk with some protein powder in it. This protein powder gives me more energy during busy morning hours. We usually prefer having a heavy breakfast and simple dinners. So today's breakfast is going to be appam and chicken curry. Appam flour can be made the previous day itself and can be kept in the fridge so that you won't have any hassle making it fresh in the mornings. Chicken curry is made and I'm heating it up just before having it. Here the temperature is too cold so the food does not stay hot for long. And on the other stove I'm making fresh hot appams just before eating. It takes quite some time to prepare the appams one by one, so during that time I'll start preparing the fruits for fresh juice. Most of us feel like having a cup of tea or coffee 1 hour after our breakfast, but having more than 2 cups of tea or coffee regularly on a daily basis is really unhealthy. To cut down on this habit, we can easily switch to fruit juices. Whenever we go to my husband's place, we get these kind of organic fruits from nearby villages. Don't they look so natural with even the leaves intact on them? These are so fresh and so healthy that once you start having them, you won't even feel like having tea or coffee again. This is one of the major differences between city life and village life. Village life, everything is fresh and organic and also you get it for a much cheaper price. But in city life, we spend so much of money trying to switch to an organic life, but we end up eating whatever's available. If you prep the fruits in the morning itself before having breakfast, it becomes an easy task to make juice later. But if we don't have them ready, we'll obviously end up making instant tea or coffee due to our laziness. My first appam is ready now. Outer layer so crispy and so soft at the center. This is how a perfect appam should look like. I've taken about 6 oranges to make fresh juice today and I've peeled all the skin from the oranges. Usually we make use of these fruit peels and vegetable peels to make natural organic compost for our plants. These natural fruit and vegetable peels increase the yield of your plants and it's so convenient to make them yourself and use it for your terrace garden. These orange peels can also be dried in natural sunlight, powdered and then used as face pack. Orange peels also helps to remove tan to a great extent. Now I have washed and kept the mixy jar ready to make this orange juice. If you have time, you can remove the seeds from these oranges and then put it into the blender. Today I don't have much time, so I'm just putting it straight into the blender, but this will give slightly a bitter taste to your juice. I'm just gonna pulse it once without adding any sugar and remove 1/2 cup of thick juice for my baby. By pulsing it only once or twice, you won't be grinding the seed so the juice won't taste bitter. I usually don't add water while making fruit juices. Some fruits like pomegranates and mangoes require some amount of water to be added, but for oranges there is absolutely no need to add any water. Even if you drink just 1/2 cup of fresh thick juice, it's really good for your health and it turns out to be very tasty too when you don't add any water. Now I have strained this juice and removed any seeds or thick pulp for my baby and I kept 1/2 glass of juice ready. Next, I'll be adding some sugar in the remaining pulp and make fresh juice for my family. I usually don't add sugar in anything for my baby, even in milk. If you've been using sugar in milk for your baby, you can substitute it with palm sugar. Palm sugar is a healthier option when compared to our refined sugar. I've been multitasking making appams and fresh juice and now about 4-5 appams are ready. It is time to serve breakfast for my husband. So while I was making all this, my husband was taking care of our child. I'm now serving appam and chicken curry in the plate for him. And I've already kept idlis and chicken soup ready for my baby. Whenever we buy chicken, we boil it and take some fresh soup out of it and then we make our desired curry out of the remaining chicken. This way our baby also gets to eat non-veg whenever we eat. The chicken soup was still hot since it was kept in the hot pack, so I'm transferring it to a feeding bowl and then I'm gonna add about 1/2 teaspoon of ghee to it. Mix it until the ghee dissolves and then add the idli and mash it well. As you can see, I have also kept the juice ready. After feeding him breakfast, I'll give about 1 hour gap and then feed him the orange juice. Now my husband is ready to have his breakfast. He's so happy and jolly today because he's having his favorite appam and chicken curry in the morning itself. If it was just idli and chutney, then you can see only a sad reaction on his face, but today he's just enjoying his food completely. And the best thing I like about him is he always chats with me whenever we have food. He never fidgets with his mobile while eating, and this is such a good habit. We enjoy chatting and eating together, and we discuss a lot of things over food. This gives a very good family bonding. And now I've prepared the breakfast for my son. My son is just the same as my husband. If it's non-veg, he'll eat happily and easily. But if it's a veg menu, then I have to really fight a war to feed him. As you can see, he's refusing to take the first mouth. Only if he takes the first mouth, he will know that it is non-veg, and then it becomes an easy task to feed him. If he wakes up early in the morning, usually I give him a glass of milk and then I'll feed him breakfast about half an hour or 45 minutes later. But today, since I'm giving a heavy breakfast with chicken soup and all that, I didn't give him any milk. I'm just feeding him the food straight away. After taking the first mouth, he understood that it is non-veg and chicken soup, so he's not refusing to take the next mouth. He's eating happily. By the time I finished making appams for my husband and finished feeding my son, I started to feel really hungry. I feel so thankful to God to eat such a delicious meal when I'm so hungry. While I was eating, my husband was making hot appams for me. You can see him running back and forth from the kitchen to the hall, taking care of my son and also making appams for me. My son was wondering what I was eating and he wanted to taste the appam. He just took one or two bites, but he was already full, so he didn't care to ask for more. Now I have finished eating, I really enjoyed my meal. Now I'm gonna start cleaning the table and the kitchen. It is not recommended to keep the same vessel in the fridge in which we cooked our meal, so I'm gonna transfer it to a smaller bowl and then put this vessel to wash. If you have any kind of premium cookware like mine, or if you have any non-stick cookware, it is highly recommended that you don't put them in the fridge. You have to transfer it into another steel bowl and then place it in the fridge. And these kind of premium cookware should be washed immediately, and you should not allow them to dry along with the food. If we follow these instructions carefully, then our cookware will be long lasting and it is much healthier for us as well. Now I have cleared our food items and the bowls and baby's food items and all the bowls and kept them wherever they are supposed to be kept. I've also made the orange juice. I'm gonna strain it and give it to my husband and father-in-law. I had half a cup of juice before starting to clean the table. This gives me some extra added energy. As you can see, we put a plastic sheet on the table, which is very easy to clean even if food spills on it. You just have to wipe it with a wet cloth and you can absolutely find no stain on it. Just one wipe will do and it will look new every time. I also wipe the chair sometimes if I find it a bit dirty. Now it's been almost 1 hour after breakfast and baby is ready to have his juice. Feeding baby milk or juice or any kind of liquids is my husband's responsibility. Only feeding breakfast, lunch and dinner is my responsibility. This is how we help each other with all the tasks in the house. We give our baby fruit juices at least thrice a week. It helps to build his immunity. While my husband was having his juice and feeding the baby, I started cleaning the kitchen. The mixer jar was dirty as I made the juice, and the appam pan was dirty, the chicken curry pan was dirty, and I have to first wash all these vessels and put them in their place. Although we have a maid for washing vessels, I prefer washing my premium cookware all by myself. By maintaining it well, these cookwares last for a long time. I also prefer to use only dishwashing liquid instead of bar soaps. Especially when we have a baby at home, we don't want to find any soap remains in the vessel. So using a quality dishwashing liquid is very effective, and also there is absolutely no chance of any remains. If you're wondering where I'm placing the vessels, you can find a small tray installed just above the sink. So when I wash these vessels and put it on top, all the water droplets will fall directly into the sink and it will not fall anywhere else and mess up the place again. After all the water is drained from the vessels, I put them back in their respective places. By following this method, the woodworks and the shelves don't get wet and they also last for a long time. While washing any kind of premium cookware, I first rinse it with water and remove all the dirt that is sticking to it. To scrub the pan, I just use a sponge like this and I don't use any kind of metal scrubber. The next thing to do is to put back the remaining appam flour in the fridge. If there is anything else remaining, I put all that into the fridge and then I clear the place completely. After clearing all the things, I just wipe the kitchen counter once with a wet cloth. This removes any hard particles sticking on the counter. Especially when we make appam or dosa, there are high chances that small bits and pieces fall behind the stove. So moving the stove and clearing it now and then helps us to maintain a clean kitchen. Today I'm removing all these plates from the stove and giving it quite a good amount of cleaning. I don't do this every day. I just use a wet piece of cloth to wipe the stove after every meal. This kind of deep cleaning is required only once a week since we don't make our stove that dirty. Again, I'm using a multi-purpose cleaning liquid to clean the stove. I'm using a scrubber to remove all the dirt that is sticking to it, putting little amount of water and wiping it with a dry cloth. This is the basic cleaning that we can do when we don't have much time. Now I have finished cleaning the kitchen counter and the stove. I usually maintain separate cloths for cleaning the kitchen. We can find very cheap cleaning cloths in the market just for 10 rupees or 20 rupees. It is a real waste to use disposable cleaning materials. Instead of that, I believe in using these kind of ordinary cloths and a good quality multi-purpose cleaner. And now comes the most important part. After cooking or cleaning, I never forget to wash my hands with a good hand wash. This removes any kind of dirt that might be sticking to my palm or nails, and also it helps to keep my hands moisturized. That's it guys, my morning routine is over and I really hope you enjoyed watching it. If you found this video to be helpful, do give a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Meet you next time in another video. Bye bye.